take the verse empty in book of Isaiah chapter 24 verse 1 to 23. Do not with people through MP3 or YouTube on the earth. We'd like to suggest the three questions. Number one and verse 1. Behold, the Lord makes the earth empty and makes it waste. Distort its surface and scatters abroad its inhabitants. What does the phrase to make the earth empty mean in the context, and what can we learn from here? Question 2 in verse 17. Fear and the pit and the snare are upon you, O inhabitants of the earth. Can you explain the pit in detail, and what does this verse in the context? Last question in verse 22. They will be gathered together as prisoners are gathered in the pit and will be shut up in the prison. After many days, they will be punished. Can you explain this verse in light of the book of Revelation, the apocalypse, and what can we learn from here? In chapter 24 to 27, Isaiah prophesied God's judgments on the entire world for its sin through the Great Tribulation, called as Isaiah Apocalypse. Apocalypse is the prophecy about the end of the world, such as the book of Revelation. In previous chapters, his prophecies were to Judah, Israel, to surrounding nations, and finally to the whole world. We adopt the literal interpretation unless the word of God is symbolically explained. Although we do not assert against any non-literal interpretations, the prophetic interpretations in eschatology. Eschatology means the Christ doctrine of the end. Millennial means 1,000 years. Rapture, every creature changed incorruptibly to be caught up together into heaven from earth at Christ's return. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16, 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 52. What a literal interpretation, non-literal interpretation, non-literal interpretation, symbolic from little to more. Millennialism, 1,000 years reign in Christ's return. Premillennialism, Christ's return before the 1,000 years reign. Pre-tribulation rapture, rapture before the Great Tribulation. Post-tribulation rapture, rapture after the Great Tribulation. So, literal interpretation is premillennialism, pre-tribulation rapture. That is actual Israel. Israel, the Israelites, different from church, the people in Christ. Actual rapture, actual millennial reign. That is a literal interpretation. Post-tribulation rapture is no actual Israel. Israel is a symbol of the church. So Great Tribulation come out, Israel come out, 144,000 Israel, they considered as a church, not actual Israel. Post-millennialism, Christ return after the 1,000 years of reign, no actual Israel, plus no actual rapture, incorruptibly changed in the rapture is a symbol of newly minded. Then a million legion, no actual 1,000 here to win. No actual Israel, no actual rapture, no actual millennial reign. Millennial reign is a symbol of the current reign and thereafter Christ. Then we see the 70 weeks of Daniel, Daniel chapter 9, verse 24-27, 74 7-year cycles for Israel in Daniel. So we live in a 69 over 7-year cycles right there. That is the big gap. That is Jesus coming again. One cycle, 1 7-year cycle left. That is the tribulation, great tribulation. Jesus coming again in heaven. That one is the one Nicodemus, the middle explained there. Satan was defeated by Jesus' death and resurrection, but not destroyed yet. So Satan still controls the world, not controlling those who are over heaven. Another reason, not controlling creatures because of the indwelling Holy Spirit, but tempting them because of flesh. In Isaiah chapter 14, verse 12, how you are fallen from heaven, O Lucifer. So fallen from heaven to earth, son of the morning, how you are cut down to the ground. You who weaken the nations. And John chapter 4, 17, verse 14, I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they are not of the world. So we do not belong to the world, just as I am not of the world. The Lord Jesus not belong to the world. Although we live in the world, a third of the angels follow the Satan, so fallen angel, one of the third, into rebellion against God. So two kingdoms in the universe exist. One is a kingdom of death and darkness, and the other is a kingdom of life and light. After the rapture of the church, the earth is ruled by Satan in Romans chapter 11, verse 25. For I do not desire, brethren, that you should be ignorant of this mystery, lest you should be wise in your own opinion. The blindness in part has happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles had come in. And in Revelation chapter 6, verses 1 and 2, now I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard one of the four living creatures saying with a voice like thunder, come and see. And I looked, and behold, a white horse. She would sat on it, had a bow, and a crown was given to him, and he went out conquering and to conquer. So this one is Satan is control. First one, behold, the Lord makes the earth empty. In the Great Tribulation, about 50% of the earth population are killed. So that is 4 over 8 billion survive. So the world is empty because God's judgment on the entire earth for its sin. Revelation chapter 6, verse 8 and 9, 18. So I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and the name of him who sat on it was Death, and Hades followed with him, and power was given to them over a fourth of the earth to kill with sword. So one of us is to kill the leopard, over four, right? With hunger, and three-fourths left with death, and by the beast of the earth. Revelation chapter 9, verse 18. Now left the three-fourths left here. By these three plagues, a third of mankind, so the third, one of the third gone, so left him. Is two of force was killed by the fire and the smoke and brimstone which came out of their mouths. Naked waste distorts its surface, scatters abroad its inhabitants. Through seal, trumpet, trial judgments such as war, famine, death, martyrs, catastrophe, and so on in Revelation chapter 6 through 18 that happened. That's why the earth, the world, was wasting. But in the pre-tribulation rapture, all Christians may escape the great tribulation, being caught up with the Lord in heaven. Luke chapter 21:36. Watch therefore and pray always, you may be counted worthy to escape all these things that will come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. Then verse 2, and it shall be as with the people, so with the priests, as with their servants, so with his master, as with the maid, so with her mistress, as with the buyer, so with their seller, as with the lender, so with the borrower, as with the creditor, so with the debtor. Everyone on the earth is not escapable from the great tribulation, regardless of individual backgrounds. Verse 3, the land shall be entirely empty. Now it's only 50% of the population left, and utterly plundered. The land is empty and wasted, for the Lord has spoken this war, because the Lord makes the judgment upon the earth with his word. Verse 4, the earth mourns and fades away, the earth weeps and perishes, the world languishes and fades away, the world weakens and perishes, the haughty people of the earth languish, the proud weakens because of God's judgment on the world against the proud. James chapter 4 says, but he gives more grace, therefore he says God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. The earth, or the world, is miserable. Then verse 5, the earth is also defiled under its inhabitants. The earth is also polluted by its people, such as air, soil, or water pollution, by covetous people, due to the failure of people's managing the earth to will be very good. Genesis chapter 1, 27, 28. God created the world, the earth, very good. So God created a man in his own image, in the image of God. He created him, male and female. He created them. Then God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion of the fish of the sea, of the birds of the air, and of every living thing that moves on the earth. So, Matthew chapter 9, 19, that is the next one. Then is because they have transgressed the laws, violated the word of God, such as the covet, divorce, homosexual marriage, unmarried cohabitants, Matthew chapter 19, verse 5 and 6, and said, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and two shall become one flesh. So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let not man separate. That's the example. The verse is not justified. So, changes the ordinance, then, it's about your abortion, lawsuit against Christians, and so on. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 6, a brother goes to the war against brother, and there are people unbelievers. That is a rhetorical, you know, exclamation, you know, no way. But it's we easily to follow suit even against Christian. Then is broken the everlasting covenant. So they forsook God. Unless the covenant is God and gospel, they simply forsook God. Verse 6, therefore the curse has devoured the earth. So the earth is cursed, and those who dwell in it are desolate. The dwellers are wasted. Therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burned. One third of the trees is burned, such as a light the wildfire. Revelation chapter 8, verse 7. The first angel sounding, and hail and fire followed, mingled with the water. And they were thrown to the earth. And a third of the trees were burned up, and all green grass was burned up, like California or Oregon wildfire, like that. Therefore, the inhabitants of the earth are burned, and few men are left, about 50%, about 4 billion world population left. Verses 7 to 12 talk about no more joy, song, musical instruments, but people are confused. The city is destroyed, and the gates is destroyed. Gates of the city gates destroyed. So let's see verse 7. The new wine fails, no more new wine. The vine languishes, the vine weakens because of fewer workers of the half world population. All the merry hearted sigh, medicine becomes sigh in the miserable world. Verse 8, the mirth of the tambourine ceases, the joy of the tambourine music instrument, the noise of jubilance, the noise of overjoyed people ends. The joy of the harp, the joy of a harp instrument, all joy are gone away. Verse 9, they shall not drink wine with a song, nor enough wine, nor song, because the vine languishes. Strong drink is bitter. Strong alcoholic drink is not tasteful. Verse 10. City of confusion is broken down. The citizens are confused, and the city is broken down. So such as the likelihood of atomic bomb by chemical weapon, pandemic viruses, and so on, in the Great Tribulation. Every house is shut up so that none may go in. Nobody travels, but they stay home. Verse 11, there is a likelihood of pandemic situations, so pandemic, the COVID-19 situation, right? Verse 11, there is a cry for wine in the streets, looking for wine, shoutily, but no enough wine. All joy is darkened, all joy fades away. The myth of the land is gone, the joy disappeared. Verse 12, in the city, desolation is left, and the gate is stricken with destruction. The city and its gates are destroyed by God's seal, trumpet, and vile judgments. Verse 7, 13, when shall be there in the midst of the land among the people? It shall be like the shaking of an olive tree, like the cleaning of grapes when their vintage is done. Among the few people of the half world population, their works are like picking up fallen olives or grapes upon the harvest. Verse 14, they shall lift up their voice, they shall sing, for the majesty of the Lord, they shall cry aloud from the sea. Those who escape God's judgment on the earth will sing to the glory of God's majesty. That is a raptured church in heaven. The church is singing to praise the Lord. Revelation chapter 5, verse 9 to 10. They sang a new song, saying, you are worthy to take the scrolls and to open the seals, for you were slain, have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and have made us kings and priests to our God, and we shall reign on the earth. That is coming again to establish millennium. Millennial kingdom. Verse 15, therefore glorify the Lord in the dawning light. Glory to the Lord from the sunrise place or the east. The name of the Lord God of Israel in the coastal lands of the sea. Glory to God Israel from every island in the sea. Verse 16, from the end of the earth. From everywhere in the earth, we have heard a song, glory to the righteous, but I said, I am ruined. Glory to the righteous God, because of God's righteous judgment on the world for its sin. But I said, I am ruined. Ruined were to me, great sorrow to me. Isaiah, because the earth is ruined. The treacherous dealers have dealt treacherously. Indeed, the treacherous dealers have dealt very treacherously. The unrighteous, the disobedient, or the betrayers are more wicked. Luke chapter 11, verse 26. Then he goes and takes with him seven others. Other evil spirits, more wicked than himself, and they enter and dwell there. And the last state of dead man is worse than the first. Verse 17, fear and the pit and the snare are upon you. The pit is the bottomless pit, abyss, or abyss, the place of demonic beasts, or their followers. Luke chapter 8:31, and they begged him, and they, his demons, begged Jesus. He would not command them to go out into the abyss or pit. Leviticus chapter 9, verse 1 to 6. And the fifth sound of sounding, and I saw a star falling from heaven to the earth. That is the fallen angel. To him was given the key to the bottomless pit, or abyss, and he opened the bottomless pit, and smoke rolled out of the pit, like the smoke of a great furnace. So the sun and the air were darkened because of the smoke of the pit. Then out of the smoke, locusts came up on the earth, and to them was given power, and the scorpions of the earth have power. They were commanded not to harm the grass of the earth, or any green thing, or any tree, but only those men who do not have the seal of God on their foreheads. And they were not given authority to kill them, but to torment them for 5 months. Their torment was like the torment of a scorpion, and it strikes a man. In those days, men would seek death and will not find it. They will desire to die, and death will flee from them. So it is the fallen star, the demons, is released from bottom speed and giving a hard time to people. So people were in a tormenting by fallen angels, but they tried to die, but not allowed that. The supplication. Also, Revelation 20, verse 1 and 2. And then I saw an angel coming down from heaven, having the key to the bottomless pit and great chain in his hand. He laid hold of the dragon, that serpent of old, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. So Satan's all, you know, follows, you know, is put into the bottomless pit. Grave means the place of death, called as Sheol in Hebrew, Hades in Greek, and Hell in English. So from being part Abraham's bosom, or paradise, one part, the other one, flame or fire part, tormented part. Luke chapter 16, verse 23-24, Jesus gave this real story. And being a torment in Hades, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. Then he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus, that he may dip his finger in water and cool my tongue. For I am tormented in this flame. So flame place or fireplace. So two parts. Upon Jesus' death, he descended into the hell to preach the death deliveries in the Old Testament in Abraham's bosom part and brought them into heaven the resurrection time. First Peter brought them to heaven and Jesus resurrected. First Peter chapter 4 6. For this reason the gospel was preached also to those who are dead in the Old Testament believers, they might be judged according to man in the flesh, but live according to God in the spirit. Ephesians chapter 4, 8 to 9. Therefore Jesus said, when Jesus ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts to man. Now this he ascended, what does it mean? But that he also first descended into the lower parts of the earth. Lower parts of the earth is Abraham's bosom or paradise. Isaiah chapter 61 and 1. The spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach the good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to captive, this one, liberty captivity, and the opening to prison those who are bound. So that's the one. And Jesus sent down into the great void. So we accept Jesus Christ. For he has spoken, because Peter said, the resurrection of the Christ. Jesus was not left in haste, nor did he the flesh see corruption. Matthew 27, verse 3. And coming out of the grave, he fell. After the resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared, and so many people went into Jesus' resurrection. So now, in New Testament, the hell has only a higher part, called as a hellfire, Matthew chapter 5, 22. But I say to you, whoever is angry with his brother without a cause shall be in danger the judgment. Whoever says to your brother Raka, Raka means stone head or empty head, birthday, shall be in danger of the council. But whoever says your fool shall be in danger of hellfire. Gehenna, the eternal place of the unrighteous. At the great white throne judgment, God will give up all of death to be alive forever in the lake of fire. So all of death in unrighteous unbelievers. See the second resurrection of the above church. So we see second resurrection. Matthew chapter 13. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come first, separate the wicked from among the just, and cast them into the furnace of fire. There will be wailing and gnashing of teeth. So that is Gehenna, lake of fire. Revelation chapter 20, 14, 15. Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire, Gehenna. This is the second death. Anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire, Gehenna, eternal place of the unrighteous people. Then is upon you, on the inhabitants of this, the fear and the peace and the snare are upon the inhabitants of the earth. How? Verse 18. And it shall be that he who flees from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit. And he will come down from the midst of the pit, shall be caught up in the snare. For the window is from on the highest are open, and the foundation of the earth are shaking. So, here, the noise of the fear leads to pit. The pit, honestly, leads to the snares. Only the demonic beings or their followers, such as the false prophet or false teachers, fall into the fear, pits, and snare. The window from on high are open, causing calamity. The foundation of the earth are shaken, earthquakes. Revelation chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. I looked into when he opened the sixth seal, and behold, there was a great earthquake. The sun became black as a sackcloth of hair, and the moon became like a blood, and the stars of heaven fell to the earth, and a fig tree drops its leg feet when it is shaken by a mighty wind. Verse 19, the earth is violently broken. There is a split open. There is a shaking exceedingly through the earthquakes. Verse 20, there is a shall reel to and fro. There is a shall staggers backward and forward like a drunkard, and shall totter like a hurt, move in an unsteady way like a shelter. It's a transgression shall be heavy upon you, and it will fall and not rise again, because their sin against God is too heavy. Theirs will pass away by melting with the fervent heat. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 12. Looking forward and hasting the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in on fire, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Revelation chapter 21, verse 1. Now I saw a new heaven and new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Verse 21. It shall come to pass in that day that the Lord will punish on high the host of the exalted ones, and on the earth the king of earth. One day the Lord will punish the demonic beings in the heavenly places and the earthly kings at the end of the great tribulation. Throughout Armageddon word, the Lord punishes them. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. For we do not wrestle against the flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against the rulers of the darkness of the age, against spiritual force of wickedness in the heavenly places. Revelation chapter 19, verse 19-20. And I saw the beast, the kings of the earth, and their armies gathered to have to make war against the Lord, who sat on the horse, and against his army. Then the beast was captured, and with him the false prophet, who worked the signs on his project, by which he deceived those who received the mark of the beast, and those who worshipped his image. These two were cast alive into the lake of fire, burning with fire strong. Verse 22. They will be gathered together as the prisoners are gathered in the pits, and will be shut up in the prison. After many days, they will be punished. After Armageddon word, the Lord fire an angel, put the demonic beings into the bottomless pit for 1,000 years. Revelation 22:3. They laid hold of the dragon, the serpent of old, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. And he cast him into the bottomless pit, and shut him up, and set a seal on him, so that he should deceive the nation no more, until the 1,000 years were finished. But after this thing, he must be released for a little while, for a little while. Then the Lord will reign the earth for 1,000 years with a rod of iron with crutches. After many days, they will be punished. After 1,000 years, the Lord will release them for a little while, who deceived people and are cast into Gehenna, the lake of fire. Why does the Lord release them? During the millennium kingdom, many people are born. Those who survive through great tribulation are allowed to live into the kingdom age. God's purpose is to examine the people's hearts to love God truly by Satan. Revelation chapter 20, verse 7-10. Now when the 1,000 years have expired, Satan will be released from his prison. Then will go out to deceive the nation, nation's people, which are in the four corners of the earth, everywhere, Gog and Magog, to gather them together to battle, whose number is at the sand of the sea, out of people. They went up on the breadth of the earth, surrounded the camp of the saints, and the blood of the city, and fire came up from God, out of heaven, and devoured them. the devil who deceived them would cast into the lake of fire, Gehenna, brimstone, where the beast and false prophet are there too, and they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. That tormented place, fireplace, the dead one, forever. Then in the verse 23, then the moon will be disgraced. Then after great tribulation, the moon will be disgraced, and the sun ashamed. The brightness of the glory of Jesus at Jesus' return on the earth is brighter than the sun and the moon. Mark chapter 9, verse 2 and 3. Now after 6 days, Jesus took Peter, James, and John, to led them up on high mountain apart by themselves. This one, Hermon Mount, and he was transfigured before them. His clothes become shining, exceedingly white, like snow, such as no longer on the earth can white them. Revelation chapter 1:16. He had in his right hand the 7 stars, out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword. And his countenance, his face was like the sun shining, his strength, right, like the sun. Matthew chapter 24, 29, 30. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened, the moon will not give its light, the stars will fall from heaven, and the powers of heaven will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with the power and great glory coming on the earth. For the Lord of hosts will reign on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, and before the elders glorious. The Lord will reign here for 1,000 years with elders and other creatures. So we covered all three questions. Let's just sing all together on both of the last song in the book, page